This video is brought to you by Squarespace. Recently, after years of faithfully using PrusaSlicer for all my 3D printing needs, I made the switch to a little known Orca Slicer. And in this video, I'm going to share why and why you too might want to consider making the jump. Let's dive in. For those of you who don't already know, really quickly, what is Orca Slicer? Basically, Orca Slicer is a fork of Bamboo Studio, which means someone took the open source code, which itself was spun off from PrusaSlicer, and spun off their own remix of sorts. This was made possible by the fact that Slicer, and therefore PrusaSlicer, have the type of license that requires anyone who modifies it to share their own code and upgrades as open source as well. As a side note, because Cura also makes their source code available online, there is already a lot of commonality between Cura, PrusaSlicer, Bamboo Studio, and so on, as evidenced by the recent migration of tree or organic supports in slight variations on each platform. In short, Orca Slicer, previously known as the Soft Fever fork, is just a fork of Bamboo Studio, which itself made a lot of improvements over PrusaSlicer. So why then would you give up on a more popular, well-supported slicer from a big-name company like Prusa or Bamboo Lab to try a new, unproven one from a relatively unknown developer? Well, there's a list of reasons. One, compatibility with more 3D printers. As I mentioned before, Bamboo Studio introduced a lot of improvements over PrusaSlicer when it hit the scene. But except for a few select printers like Vorons or Prusa Minis, Bamboo did not make its slicer compatible with every other printer out there. Far from it. Therefore, if you wanted to enjoy the upgraded experience of Bamboo Studio, or you just wanted to use the same slicer for your Bamboo Lab printer as you use for your other printers, you were kind of out of luck. All of that changes with Orca Slicer. Now you have all the compatibility and benefits of Bamboo Studio, but with the ability to add your own custom printers or import a growing list of ready-made profiles for everything from Delta printers to Creality printers and much, much more. Number two is one app for everything. As I mentioned in my review of the Bamboo Lab X1 Carbon, one of my absolute favorite features of the Bamboo Lab ecosystem is the integrated printer management. Instead of needing one app for slicing and then a web app and browser for managing the printer, Bamboo Studio integrated it all into a tab right in the slicing app. However, if you were to add even one of the limited printers that they are making available in the Bamboo Studio, this functionality was disabled. Orca Slicer solved this by simply creating a browser window right in that tab of the app for any other printer. You can therefore access your Octoprint, Mainsail, Fluid, or any other printer web interface directly from within the slicer. I don't know about you, but with all the printers I'm running, that is way fewer browser tabs and apps open on my computer. Three, user interface improvements. When I asked all of you on Twitter, one of the most common responses I received for why people were switching over was the improved user interface and experience. People love that Bamboo Studio improved upon PrusaSlicer, giving it a more Cura feel, and many people feel that the menus and organization of the different settings are more logical. Now, with Orca Slicer, everyone can enjoy that improved interface regardless of what printer they have. That's three down, and I've got three more for you, but first, while we are on the topic of published easy-to-use software, I do have to thank our video sponsor, which is Squarespace. Whether you're looking to build an e-commerce website, a portfolio website, a blog, or anything in between, Squarespace makes it incredibly easy with their website builder, and they handle all of the technical aspects like software updates, security, and so on. I've actually used Squarespace products for years, specifically their scheduling product, and I love how easy it makes things. Plus, I've always experienced incredible customer service from them. So to support the channel and create your own dream website, head over to squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/thenextlayer to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. All right, let's get back into the video with number four, built-in calibration tests. Another one of the wow features of Orca Slicer is the set of built-in calibration and flow tests. It's such a simple thing, but I don't know why nobody thought of this before. With one click of the tool menu, you can select from a growing list of powerful calibration tests, which make it so much easier to fine-tune your prints, printers, and filaments. Which leads us to 5, more granular settings. For whatever reason, some settings are disabled in Bamboo Studio, perhaps to try to pressure you into using approved filaments. One major example, pointed out by some of you on Twitter, is the ability to alter the pressure, advance, and max flow rate settings of individual filaments, which many of you on Twitter told me were sorely missing. But that's not all. Orca Slicer also enables you to remove the flow calibration pattern from the build plate so you can get more print area on your Bamboo Lab build plate. And as one user pointed out on Twitter, it re-enables the ability to add custom profiles as well. 6, for users by users. Last but certainly not least, Orca Slicer is made and maintained by a member of the 3D printing community, which, as Soft Fever himself pointed out, means that the changes that he has made are done with usability of consumers like you and me in mind. Not only that, but I think it's important to support variety, competition, and innovation because, as we have seen in recent years on the hardware side, even innovation by end users in the community can push companies to innovate more. I mean, I don't think that we would have seen or ever gotten the Bamboo Lab printers, for example, if it weren't for the Voron project. So when an independent developer decides to take things into their own hands and make improvements that the big companies themselves can't or won't, it can only benefit us as users. So on that note, if you do decide to check out Orca Slicer, do consider dropping Soft Fever, the developer, a few bucks via his donation link in the description below so that he can continue, or she, to do this awesome work, which they do completely for free for all of us. That's all for now, but I would love to know in the comments below if you've tried out Orca Slicer or if you're considering making the switch over. Once again, thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Thanks to all of you for watching, liking, commenting, subscribing, and maybe checking out some of those referral links in the description. And of course, thank you to my wonderful Patreon subscribers and supporters who have helped me make this a full-time job in my brand new studio. I promise you lots of exciting updates are coming soon. That's all for today, but I'll see all of you on the next layer. Bye.